welcome to MCN, and this is a bike that I've been wanting Triumph to build for a long time. This is a 765 Daytona. It's actually their Moto2 limited edition bike. Only 765 are being built in America and Canada, and 765 in the rest of the world. But we've been riding it today on the road and track, and I absolutely love it. To ride, it's everything I dreamt it would be. So basically, you've got a 675R chassis, which is one of the most sweet handling chassis ever built, in my opinion. It's really agile, it's really easy to ride, and the 675R engine isn't too shabby, but this 765 engine is out of the Street Triple RS, and then it's breathed on to produce more power. So it's got 128 bhp, and the bike weighs 165 kilos dry. Now, on the road, the reason I love it so much is I've always been a fan of the GSX-R 750, and this is kind of Triumph's GSX-R 750. So you've got a bike that has got all the good bits of a 600, so it's very agile, very involving. The engine screams, the engine's fantastic. But you've got a little bit more torque, so you're never dancing up and down the gears just to keep it on the boil. You can actually be quite lazy with the revs if you want to and use the torque, or you can scream it like a 600 and get all that jazzy good stuff off of it. To look at, it's probably not as good for me. £15,000 this cost. Actually, it's £15,765. It just looks a little bit old design, and I know a lot of people on our comments section on Facebook and YouTube have said a similar thing. And for me, it's kind of hasn't moved on from the mid-noughties. And especially with the frame unpainted, which Triumph says helps lose weight, it kind of looks a little bit old-fashioned. You know, the overhangs are quite long. This tail unit sticks further than the back wheel. The nose protrudes a little bit too much. And with this silver frame, it kind of reminds me of an old R6 or an SV650, which when you're spending that amount of money, I don't know, because a Panigale V2 is exactly the same price. Well, actually, it's a little bit cheaper. And that thing's jewel-like by comparison. The other thing I'm not too keen on is some of the attention to detail. So for example, these switchgear blocks are obviously off another bike, a more modern Triumph than the Daytona. And you've actually got a bit of blanking switch there, which on another bike would have done traction control or cruise control or whatever. So I'd be a bit miffed with that for 15 grand. And also the wiring loom is too long, where this switchgear's obviously gone on a bike with higher bars. So I'd be a little bit disappointed with that, but to ride, it's fantastic, like I say, and it has got a lot of nice detail. Now, modern generation Triumphs, the quality is up there, it's amazing. And it does show that this is an older generation Triumph, and the build quality and the attention to detail isn't quite as good, but it is still very good, and you get a lot of nice parts. So with the 765, you've got fully carbon fiber bodywork, tail unit, single seat, fairing, hugger, front mud guard, billet aluminium top yoke, which is numbered. So this actual bike is number 74 out of 765. You've got a colour dash, you've got traction control, you've got rider modes, quick shifter, auto blipper. So in terms of the equipment, it's got everything. And because it's based on a 675R, you've got full O-lins, O-lins rear shock, O-lins forks, O-lins steering damper. It comes with Brembos, it comes with Super Corsa SPs. So all the performance is there. On the track, it's really easy to ride fast. A bit like a GSX-R 750 or a Panigale V2. It doesn't take much effort. You haven't got too much power there. Problem with 200 horsepower superbike is that really it's always riding you. On the road, it's basically on tick over. On the track, you've really got to know what you're doing to get the best out of it. And me included, I can't get the best out of a superbike. You've got to be a pro racer to really get the best out of it. And it kind of leaves you feeling a little bit flat sometimes. But with this, this flatters you. You feel like you're riding it. You can use every ounce of the power. And the riding styles are kind of a cross between a 600 and a 1000. So in some corners, you can carry loads and loads of corner speed. And it's very agile, because it's got a 180 rear tire. Superbike's got a 200 section, which makes them a bit clumsy. But there's still enough power for some corners, like slow corners, you can pick it up like a superbike and blast it out. And to be honest, it will keep up with the superbike here at Cadwell, almost down halfway down the back straight. It'll also wheelie in first and second without even trying. You can clutch it up in third, and the traction control doesn't get in the way, which is really good fun. So it's really fun, really exciting bike. A lot of people have asked me if Triumph are going to go full production with this bike, and they said no, and I believe them, because there isn't really the appetite for sports bikes anymore. And you can kind of see why, because riding this around the MCN 250 route for a couple of days, it is quite uncomfortable. It's very wristy, physically quite small, pegs are quite high, although the seat's quite comfortable. And when this came out of the factory, the levers are kind of pointing at the sky, and the back brake lever was too high, so I've adjusted that, so it's a little bit more comfortable. But you can see why people of my age and above want to go adventure bikes and retros and that kind of stuff, because to live with, sports bikes aren't really where it's at anymore. And I think even when the 675R came out, 2013 I think was the last one, I remember going on the launch of that, and Triumph kind of said to me that they almost didn't make that bike because the 600 market had already gone at that point. So for them to develop a new 765 for the road sounds really nice, but I don't think they're really going to do it. So in summary, this is the bike I was hoping for. It's really fast, it's really easy, it's really involving, it's really exciting. I don't like the way it looks so much. I don't like some of the attention to detail. But if this really is a limited edition, then I guess you could say it's worth the money. But it's a lot of fun.